Hello students, welcome back. In continuation to the chapter Organizational Cleaning, here's the subtopic of that chapter which states design features that simplify cleaning. Myself, Paramveer Singh, Associate Professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. So let's begin. What do you mean by design features that simplify cleaning? These are basically the design of the furniture or the building or the interior, which is designed in such a way that it helps us in cleaning that area more efficiently, so that we can clean that area in a proper way and no dust or dirt left behind. So let's begin. Smooth textures, straight, neat and smooth lines and medium toned colors are some of the design features in a surface that make for easier cleaning. Smooth texture, smooth surfaces, no more curves, straight lines, smooth lines, and the colors which are not dark, the medium toned colors, they helps us in cleaning those areas more efficiently. Surfaces with these features collect less dust as compared to surfaces with rough textures, intricate raised patterns and grooves. To clean between the lines or inside the grooves or the raised areas, behind the raised areas, it is very difficult to clean, and that design is not appropriate to clean. Although it look more elegant or more good, but it is very hard to clean. Medium tone colors show less dirt than surfaces of darker or lighter shades. If you have a dark shade, you will find dust on it very easily. If you have a lighter shade, again you'll find dust. But if you have a medium toned colors, you might not find dirt more easily, and that again helps us in cleaning. Furniture should be so designed that cleaning under and behind them is easy. Furniture should be designed in a way that whenever possible you can easily move it, you can easily handle it, and again that will help us in cleaning that area where the furniture is more efficiently. Furnitures on caster wheels are easily movable, making cleaning under and behind them easier. Now, casters are the rollers or the small tires which are fit on the legs of the furniture. With that, it is very easy to move them, and only a single person can move them easily. Bed frames should not have a raised edge. Though raised edges helps to keep the mattresses sunk in place, they may graze the hands of GRAs badly during bed making. When we have a bed frame, we raise the sides little bit so that the mattress can stay at one place. But while cleaning, while doing the dusting or while making the bed, GRA might get hurt because of that. Because that is stuck with the nails, and nails might ooze out and it might hurt, or it might it might torn the linen. So that's why again that feature or that design has to be altered. With regard to carpets, the shorter the carpet pile, it is easier to clean. Now, pile is the face of the carpet, the cushioning effect. Pile gives the cushioning effect on which you walk. If they are shorter, it is easy to clean. You can easily vacuum clean it. You can easily, if it is a rug carpet, you can easily take it and you can remove the dust in the outer surface. But if the pile is of higher length, if it is more lengthier than the normal size, then the dirt or the dust might get stuck into it, and it will be very difficult to remove even with the vacuum cleaning or the suction cleaning. Upholstery too should have the minimum of decorative features such as buttons, gathers, etc. upholstery, like you have curtains, there are various design on instead of palmettes, or you can like nowadays it is rings or and the curtain rods which are visible. Earlier there was a design with the buttons. You have a hook which is attached with the button and you can hang it on the curtain rod. Again, those things accumulate dust and those things are not easy to clean. One reason it is on a height, and other is buttons have very small holes and buttons, they can like easily accumulate dust, so it is very difficult to clean. Surfaces such as solid wood are now being substituted by laminates wherever possible. Laminates are easy to clean and easy to maintain as compared to wood. While solid wood requires regular buffing and polishing, whereas laminates are low maintenance surface. Laminate, it has a shiny surface, you can easily clean it with a damp duster, whereas a wood which requires high maintenance and it is easily damageable, like a small nail or soil can easily scratch the wood, then you again have to do the buffing and the polishing, whereas on laminates these things can be avoided. A regular damp dusting is usually sufficient for laminates. As I have just said, the drawback of laminate is that they lack the richness and elegance of solid wood. Yes, wood gives more heavier and denser look, whereas laminates gives lighter look. So that's the reason many people go for the wooden furniture or the solid wood furnitures, but laminates are more easy to clean as compared to solid wood. Wood polishes are stain resistant and long lasting, and these are a boon to housekeepers as wooden surfaces become fairly easy to maintain with the use of these polishes. Nowadays we have various polishes which we apply on the wooden surface. Earlier it was paint, now we have polishes which are more easy to put on the woods, and it is easy to maintain the wooden furnitures. Another high maintenance surface that requires constant polishing is brass. Brass, it gets tarnished easily when it comes in contact with the moisture which is there in the air. Then we have to keep on polishing it on regular basis so that it keeps on shining. Brass becomes easily tarnished, as more so in coastal climates. Laminated brass surfaces are easier to maintain as they do not require regular polishing and should be preferred in hotels. Now even hotels or at homes also people prefer laminated brass which don't require polishing on regular intervals, and it can be easily maintained with just a dusting purpose. That's all for today, and in the next video we will discuss about use and care of cleaning equipments used in housekeeping department. Till then, thank you, have a nice day and be safe.